Corneal map-dot-fingerprint dystrophy is by far the most common corneal dystrophy and is named for the appearance of its characteristic slit lamp findings. Map-dot-fingerprint dystrophy is also known as epithelial basement membrane dystrophy. Anterior basement membrane dystrophy and Cogan microcystic epithelial dystrophy. Historically, corneal dystrophies are usually described as hereditary, bilateral, progressive, and not associated with systemic or local disease. However, in most cases, map-dot-fingerprint dystrophy is sporadic and may be a degenerative rather than familial condition. Map-dot-fingerprint dystrophy, which usually develops in both eyes, usually affects adults between the age of 40 and 70, although it can develop earlier in life. Most often, the affected epithelium will have a mype-like appearance, large, slightly grey outlines that look like a continent on a map. There may also be clusters of opaque dots underneath or close to the map-like patches. Less frequently, the irregular basement membrane will form concentric lines in the central cornea that resemble a small fingerprint. Patients may present with mild fluctuations in vision or mild foreign body sensation. They may also have a history of recurrent corneal erosion. Recurrent corneal erosions usually present with eye pain, sometimes severe, in the middle of the night or immediately upon opening the eyes in the morning. There is great variability in the severity of pain and the frequency of recurrence. The goal of management is to improve vision and to reduce the rate of recurrence of recurrent corneal erosions. First-line treatment options usually involve the use of nighttime lubricating ointments or hypertonic saline ointments. Extended bandage contact lens wear can be of benefit in reducing the rate of recurrent erosions. There is some evidence that topical steroids or oral doxycycline might provide some benefit for patients with frequently occurring erosions. Anterior stromal puncture outside the visual axis. Yak laser micropuncture. Cautery. Epithelium debridement. Diamond burr polishing. Phototherapeutic keratectomy. More recently, some ophthalmologists have touted the use of autologous serum tears or amniotic membranes. The prognosis is very variable. The disease tends to progress with age, although many patients can experience a waxing and waning of symptoms throughout their lives, or even an improvement over time.